Hey guys, welcome to Yoga Mat Week on my channel. And today I wanted to take a quick time out to talk about the difference between open cell and closed cell construction when it comes to making yoga mats. So my favorite example of an open cell mat would be the jade mat, which we've looked at. Open cell means the mat is porous and moisture permeable. Since they absorb perspiration, they can be great in sweaty or humid situations and maintain good traction. The disadvantage with open cell mats is that they can be hard to clean and they can breed bacteria. Open cell mats can also wear out more quickly, especially if you're using them vigorously every single day or multiple times a day. Closed cell mats are denser with an impermeable surface. And when I think closed cell, I think Manduka. Closed cell mats are more resistant to wear and can be considered more hygienic. The downside with closed cell mats is that they can become very slick, especially with moisture and sweat. So maybe aren't awesome for hot yogis or people who are doing like an acrobatic practice. My big advice to you is to kind of forget about all the words and just try out a jade mat, a Manduka mat, and you'll see that there's a really big difference between these two brands, jade being open cell construction and Manduka being closed cell construction. Next time you're at a yoga studio that rents mats, hopefully they carry Manduka or jade so you can try it out yourself for free. I personally prefer open cell mats just because it's so much stickier and non-slip, in my opinion, than closed cell mats, but every yogi has to make that choice for him or herself. Stay tuned for more yoga mat reviews, fun facts, and learning here with me on Yoga Mat Week, and I'll see you in my next video.